Hello everyone, Carrie from True Audio here. The D16 amplifier has made it easier than ever to add subwoofers to any multi-room sound system. In this video, we're going to show you the multiple ways to utilize the subwoofer outputs on the D16. The easiest and most effective way to add a subwoofer in a project is to use our IC-Sub-8. Start by installing the IC-Sub-8 and a pair of in-ceiling speakers in the room of your choice. Now let's take a look at the back of the D16. For this example, we will be using zone 1 for the speakers and zone 2 for the subwoofer. First, we're going to connect the audio source to zone 1. We're using a Vessel A1 as our audio source in this example. We'll take an RCA cable from the A1 to the inputs on zone 1. Make sure that you've also have the dip switches moved over to the line in position. Now we're going to connect the speakers from the room to zone 1 on the D16. Simply use the Phoenix connector provided, follow the positive negative, and plug it into the amplifier. The last step in this process is to connect the subwoofer zone, which will be zone 2. All you need to do is take from zone 1, from the output, the subwoofer output, a single RCA, and plug it into zone 2 on the left side input. Switch over into the bridge mode on the dip switch. Then you're going to connect the speaker cables going to the IC-Sub-8 to the Phoenix connector in the bridged mode configuration, meaning the positive is all the way to the left and the negative is all the way to the right. Connect that to the D16 and you're just about ready to go. Once you have an audio source connected to zone 1, we can fine-tune the IC-Sub-8 by simply using the crossover adjustments on zone 1. This will affect the subwoofer output from zone 1 to zone 2. There's no question the D16 is a great solution for new projects, but don't forget about your previous jobs. The D16 makes it possible to go back and upgrade any room with a pair of speakers and retrofit an IC-Sub-8 for the extra bump. Let's take a look at what it takes to upgrade an existing pair of speakers with an IC-Sub-8. We're going to start in the room where the speakers are. First, you want to cut in and install an IC-Sub-8 near the left or right speaker. Let's say it's the left speaker. We cut the subwoofer in. We're going to take the speaker wire from the left speaker and connect it to the IC-Sub-8. Then, from the left speaker, you need to get a new wire connected to the right speaker. So these two speakers are now run in parallel. Now let's finish this retrofit at the D16. First thing you need to do is, in zone 1, you need to mono the signal, the left and right, because we have both speakers running in parallel now. So we'll combine the left and right signals into the left side. Make sure that your dip switch is to line in. And we're going to connect those paralleled speakers, the left and right speakers that are coming from the room, on the left side of the Phoenix connector. We can accomplish this because we have two 8-ohm speakers in the room that are run in parallel, running back to the amplifier that is a 4-ohm load stable amplifier. Now we're going to connect the subwoofer to zone 2. And we're going to do this the same way we did in the first example. We're going to take from zone 1 the subwoofer out to the left side of the zone 2, making sure that your inputs are at line level in. Change the dip switch to the bridged mode. And you're going to connect the IC-Sub to the Phoenix connector in the bridge configuration. So all the way to the left and all the way to the right to maximize the power. If you want to pair the D16 with a freestanding powered subwoofer or a passive subwoofer that requires an external sub-amplifier like the True S500 DSP, it's just as easy. So in this type of installation, in addition to your speaker cables coming from the room, you will also need some type of RCA or coax cable that we'll be using for the subwoofer output. First step is you're going to use your audio source connected to that zone. Adjust your dip switches to the proper input settings. And then you're going to use that RCA cable and connect it to the subwoofer output on that zone. That's going to be connected to your powered amplifier or powered subwoofer. We recommend at the subwoofer location that you use a Y connector and go into both left and right inputs on the back of any of our subwoofers. That will help increase the output on the subwoofers. Lastly, you need to connect the speakers from that room using the Phoenix connector on the D16. And that's it. Thanks for watching. For more information, visit trueaudio.com.